Raw Rock, and who's taking Hit Raw Rock? Which one do you want?
Hit.
Hit Raw Rock, alright. So for everyone that hits, I'll take Block.
Alright. I gotta see that move.
Look at this character. This character is beautiful.
Well, while we're doing button checks, I'll explain like the way she works. So her movement, that's all invincible, by the way.
So
the way it works, like A, B, and C are not like light, medium, and heavy. They're different spells. So it's water, wind, and fire. And so for rock, you need water, fire, fire. You need to hit.
So you're playing, what's that game? Magicka? On PC?
Something like that. Like
combining elements for different spells?
Yeah, you need to combine elements. Yeah, exactly.
So you have to do a combo with ACC?
You don't even have to combo. They just have to block it. Hit or block, it builds it. There's one, so he needs two fires now. So you'll see him use fire. And good for him, fire is one of the best. Fire sweep is one of the best. There it is.
There it is, too. So he has rock, right?
He has rock.
Yeah, I have to see this.
So when does he throw it out?
He'll get in there.
With the club? Oh, he hit him.
Oh. Can you explain the little window above 9's bar? So you can stock a spell.
Yeah.
You can save a spell or use a spell that's already selected.
Yeah, okay. You can save a spell. So there's rock. Yeah. All right. So we have no raw rocks yet. Two fires. He's baiting with those fires. Now 9 does have a DP that's pretty safe, but it won't save her here.
Can Arcuna still do double super?
Yes.
Oh.
Wow, what a punish.
Okay.
Smart. Are we never going to see rocks here?
All right, sweet. That's fine with me.
You know, I didn't want to drink anyway. I love being sober. Straight edge for life.
You can definitely see him. It kind of influences the... they don't have to be in any particular order, but... You can definitely see what he wants based on what buttons he's hitting.
This character is awesome.
Alright, that wasn't a combo, it doesn't count. One block, wow. Damn, it's one for me.
So that's it? She just does it in the air?
She can do it in the air, ground, doesn't matter. And there's no recovery, so she does it at the top of the screen, she like falls down and hits a button too.
Wow.
Can you throw away spells if you get a spell that you don't want?
You just hit them. And the spell automatically changes.
Is that the DP you're talking about?
Yeah. They got baited, though. So when the air around her explodes, that's invincible. And it's hard to punish for some reason.
I mean, you did it fine. Sabi?
Well, yeah, if you make it whiff. If you make it whiff and curse, yeah, it's pretty easy to punish.
Yeah. Well, what happened to Hibiki? Actually, Hibiki versus Arcune.
Probably because this Hibiki versus 9 would be just awful. It'd be not fun. 9's really good.
Wait, who's Kubo? You? Arcune or 9?
Who is Kubo? Art?
Kubo is a famous anime player.
Right.
Is he player 2?
Thank you, Art.
He's player 2.
Okay.
I mean, like,
thank
you
know.
I hear what you all can say.
Nice.
Score 1-0?
Yeah. 9, Arcune 1, so it's 1-0. All right, he's got rock. It's coming. This character's so annoying. Ah, 2 block. God, I should have taken hit. Oh, there's 1 hit.
All right.
Is that raw? I guess that was raw.
That was raw.
Okay, 1 hit.
Wow, look at that movement. She gets 3 air dashes. Oh man,
he stood up.
Her dashes being invincible are great. It's a fun thing.
Yeah, this character looks fun.
Yeah, she does.
All right. Why is that invincible? I don't know. I want to do it, though.
Yeah. Oh. 3! Oh, my God. This guy's defense is too good.
Why is rock so good? Like, why will it open up?
Because unlike other sort of overhead things...
Oh, it's overhead.
It's an overhead.
Oh, okay.
And, but unlike, you know, like, Gatling overheads are pretty good.
Yeah.
But then... It's a special that you catch from anything, so it's like Gauntlet Hades, except Gauntlet Hades is, of course, punishable if you block it. You can't punish her for using rock. Just throw rock out. Like, it doesn't matter.
Can you convert off of the hit rock?
Yeah, that's two hits.
That was a raw.
That was a reset.
That was a reset.
Oh, that's disgusting.
Yeah, you gotta pay attention, man.
Oh, that was disgusting. So can she convert off Rock, say, like, mid-screen, far away?
Rock doesn't go all the way tracking.
Okay.
It does have a set distance, but yes. If Rock hits, for the most part, she can usually convert. Four. Damn. That was combo.
What is that about? Good lord.
Hellfire. She's powering up her fire spells.
Okay.
Alright, yeah, it's fast. You're right. It's
yeah,
fast.
It's obnoxious.
It's fast.
It's obnoxious, and you can't punish her for doing it.
And she can combo into it.
And she can combo into it. It's so annoying. So there's one more match, because that was 1-1. And you're at 3, and I'm at 4.
So does she... I didn't really pay attention. Does she make any strange, unique movements when she's casting Rock? Like, can you look at her and tell that she's casting Rock?
You just look at the Rock. You look at what spell she has.
Oh, that makes sense. Yeah.
The wheel of fate is turning. And you have to pay attention to her block strings, too, because a lot of the time she'll just do a water, fire, fire block string and immediately do Rock, so you don't even have time to look at it. Hellfire.
So what is stop then? Is that like Tetris where you can like save a spell?
You can save a spell to use later. Or if you have a spell stocked up when you do one of her supers, it powers up the super too.
Okay.
Curse.
Does she have low health?
No, I don't think so. I think it's pretty standard health. I don't know the health values in this game. Wow, he blocked that. He could go into overdrive again if he wants. I don't know if he'll curse.
Oh, what the hell was that?
That was her 4B, I believe.
Wow,
yeah.
Hit behind her?
Yeah.
She has like 3 different NA airs. They're all pretty good. The fire one hits really far. 4B hits like straight up above her.
Oh.
Fire.
Yeah, Kubo's been blocking all those 6A's, but not that time, I guess.
5?
Oh.
6?
7?
It's not looking good.
Not looking good for me. Not looking good for old guy, man.
We're gonna have to bust out the GoPro. I can't wait.
Hey, I said drinks, not full. I meant like 1, 2. Leave me alone. I gotta do stuff tomorrow too.
That's how you get good at tournaments though. This is training.
Alright, she's in curse. I mean, it's pretty hard for her to deal with curse. Like most characters. This is probably
like,
it.
Like all characters. That way you could have done it again.
Yeah, you could have.
Yeah.
Alright, well, so 3-7?
3-7. I'll see you later tonight.
Alright, sounds good.
Man, where are the people to tag us
up?
I'm starving.
Yo, they still might be playing.
Hey guys, so we had some communication issues. It was actually Soji and Con Pito.
Okay.
And now it's Sadi versus Kubo. All
right.
Very sorry about that.
All right, that makes sense, because that definitely was Soji's Arakune, but...
Soji's still the strongest Arakune?
Yeah.
Yeah.
He doesn't even play this game that much, too. That's what's funny to me. It's like, legit, he practices Guilty Gear mostly now.
Oh.
He, like, plays Bedman, right? But then every now and then, he'll just sit down, he'll sit down, he put a coin in, and he'll play, like, 20 games of BB, and you're like, oh.
Put a coin in and play 20 games. That's great.
Yeah, I mean,
I wish I was good at any fighting game.
Yeah, who are you to stop him? Like, what are you gonna do? Sit down and beat Soji? Okay.
Stickbug finally joined us.
Hi, Stickbug. You feel like hopping on?
Do you want?
Come on, man.
Come on, man. Tag us out.
Come on, man.
We're struggling. Did you eat yet?
What?
Did you eat yet? Me too. So we're all dying here.
Yo, are the Canadians out of Kohime? Are they still playing?
No, apparently.
I was like trying to get Pedro or Bryce to commentate. Pedro's actually got good commentary.
All right, so now it's Sadi versus Kubo for real.
Sadi versus Kubo for real. Hey, we got another nine.
All right.
Nine?
Yeah. Nine.
Are we still playing the blocked hit rock
game? I don't know, man. I'm already like 7-3 right now.
That's okay. So is Hibiki good?
Hibiki, of the new characters, Naoto, Hibiki, and the starting new characters were Naoto, Hibiki, and
nine.
Hibiki's better than Naoto, much worse than nine.
Okay. Yeah, he looked really cool when you know, his gameplay trailer was released or leaked or whatever. But then after that, I don't really see a lot of them.
The thing is, he has all the tools to win, but like I said, this game is pretty dominated by bullshit.
Yeah, you can't be an honest character.
Any honest character gets pooped on.
Like, is Naoto honest?
He's
super honest.
He's a K-Web character.
Who's Wi-Fi? Can I get to it?
It doesn't get service in here, which is why I turned it off.
Damn.
Take that.
Did you finally get data?
No, I did.
Oh my god.
I live in the dark.
How do you
ages.
Live in Japan and like not have data? That's so hard.
I disconnect from the world and I enjoy nature because that's me, man.
How about that?
This doesn't look like Kubo. This doesn't look like Kubo versus Sadie.
I did like enjoy watching Hibiki. The jump C looks very fun.
The character looks really cool.
The jump C is the best button I've ever seen. It's huge and it has like long hits done. And he has a godlike theme too. This is his theme in the background.
Whoa. Alright, I forgot about those. Do you know about Akatsuki BlizzCon?
Oh yeah, I know about Nazi Puncher, yeah.
Yeah.
I've only played it a couple times.
But you know the character Rokumo, right?
Yes.
Yeah, that's what it reminds me of.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, Guy Mayer here is like, what's Akatsuki?
You,
yeah,
what's you play that game, right?
No.
I play it with Andrew.
Yeah. Do you need to bully you yet?
Listen, all I know is that one Blitz Tank combo video where then it's just Blitz Tank dancing. That's what I know. And then I know that like, the guy with the shades takes off his glasses and it's edgy. So, of course, that's the character I would play.
What's his name? Kai?
Sai.
Sai.
I don't want to play that game.
Alright, meanwhile, in the background.
Fatal
counter.
Yeah. I imagine Hibiki would do pretty good in this matchup. He doesn't really have to commit.
Yeah, he can choose to stay back.
So cool. 4K? 4.5?
It was a fatal count of 60 stars.
Oh, okay.
Whoa. Back dash. So
far,
he
does have a
DP. What do you do? Oh god. What is that? Is that not
that's
a DP?
That's his DP. Now the funny thing about that DP is if you rapid cancel it, you have the option to do a high or a low.
Oh wow.
Because he's technically considered airborne. So you rapid cancel, bop, and you immediately do jump B and it's a high. Or you rapid cancel and you wait a second, you do 2B, it's a low. It's pretty dirty, especially doing it on someone's wake up.
I'm about that. Oh wow, good punch.
That's across the B, yeah, but kind of slow.
Okay, yeah, I feel the track. I hear the
piano.
Yeah, I feel it.
What gets me is the bass in the beginning. So good.
Yeah, Sonic really landing these throws.
All right, he's gonna rapid cancel.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, this is the first Taker match I've seen here today, where Taker's finally like getting the chance to land the throw.
Game one goes to Sadi, pretty convincingly. Outside of that perfect.
Yeah, outside of that perfect. Kubo like kind of went in.
He must have made adjustments. Three people on commentary.
This is the tech.
If you want to call it commentary.
This is next level.
This is the tech.
This is basically a podcast with a video game on in the background.
The thing is, like, I'm dying, so I can't give it my all.
Yeah, I really don't play this game. I'm hungry.
It's So we don't all play this game, so we need three people to commentate.
Together we make one sort of competent BB commentator.
Where's Decibro when you need him?
Damn.
I take offense to that.
Kubo needs to be careful with those DPs.
Can he hit that hitbox when he's doing that full screen like running?
Yes.
So you can hit him out.
You can hit the shadow and it makes the shadow disappear.
Oh. But does it get hurt?
No.
No.
That only happens with Chizuru,
yeah,
right?
That's what I was thinking.
She's still super strong.
Yeah.
Reaction. Overhead.
What? Ah,
oh my god.
Dead angle, trying to keep him in the corner, not happening.
Yeah, there's so many turns, so like dead angle, counter, what's it called in this game? Counter assault?
Yeah, counter assault.
Low back.
I always alpha call counter. I called Street Fighter V dead angle. I just call it dead angle. Can't escape.
Alpha counter.
Wow. What button was Hibiki pushing?
I have no idea. Probably jump C.
Oh god, oh. Right into his hands.
Yeah, Kubo.
Got the finger.
Kubo needs to keep an eye on what's hitting him.
But the thing is, like, Kubo, like, that first round, he was doing what he's doing now. And Sadi wasn't, like, adapting to it. He was just getting hit. Now Sadi's, like, you know, through.
Yeah, well, oh, what happened? All right, sweet. Dash right into my hand.
Yeah. Oh, God.
This is looking over.
Astral him. Do it. Tiger Astral. Let's see it.
Hey.
Wow. Oh, yeah, full through. What's the open? Nothing.
Jump C. Jump C is okay.
Oh, overdrive.
That was pretty good. That was good. I like that answer. Sadi takes it pretty convincingly. Kubo did not adjust to Sadi's adjustments.
I thought that matchup was going to be pretty good, but apparently I guess not.
Yeah. Kubo was doing well in the first round from doing whatever he wanted, and then after that, when he saw him adjusting, he should have slowed it down a little bit.
Yeah.
But then you saw instances like he didn't confirm a full screen D, and he dashed in with the thing, and Sadi just was like, okay, grabbed him and threw him up there. Like dashing right into Tager's waiting arms. Those big man hands.
I want a hug from Tager.
Man.
Looks like a soft, cuddly individual. I mean, with these nerves, his hugs are probably pretty nice.
I mean, he probably has like a lot of static shock issues. Probably shocks you every time he touches you. I don't know, man. I don't like static shock. Don't touch me. Don't static shock me.
Don't touch me.
Don't touch me.
Don't touch me.
Another break. Do we know who's lined up next?
Art. Do you know if we're in losers or winners yet?
This is winners round 5. We have Matoi versus Tsujikawa.
Matoi.
Oh, boy.
Matoi special.
Tsuji, one of my favorite Slayer players ever. He left us for better lands. Matoi still playing Tao?
He's playing Kokonoe, I saw earlier.
Man, I like... I just like hearing the name Matoi, because I just remember... All right, so those of you guys at home that don't know the Japanese players at Evo at Vegas... They love to gamble, and they're so bad at it. They are so bad. They don't have control. They make the weirdest bets, and they just go in, and then, you know, Matoi hits a really big hand, everyone gets excited, and then they all lose it all. They all lose it
all. What game do they play?
It was like Blackjack. But, like, they're hitting, like, on really bad hits and staying on really bad cards. Like, if you were there, you'd be like, what are they doing?
That's funny.
How much did they win, and how much did they lose?
I heard Matoi special was like he just did one hand and it went up like 900, 800.
Oh my god.
And then he lost it. He lost it all.
Oh
and like
my
he went,
god.
He went down. Same thing with Dora.
You can't really gamble here, can you? It's all like pachinko and
it's
slot.
Illegal.
It's illegal.
It's illegal. All those pachinko and slot places are like
funny. Loopholes.
Yeah,
I remember you telling me about the window next door where you can trade in your...
Yeah. Do you know what prizes they actually get if you actually trade in the balls for actual prizes?
No.
No.
I don't go to pachinko. Why?
I don't know. Because I was like, you know, outside of like the illicit, you know, the money trading thing. Like, what do you actually get? Like cigarettes, candy?
cigarettes and
you
candy.
Probably get like one of those little sticky hands.
You know, oh, hell yeah.
Whack.
Maybe like a little plastic ring.
Yeah, a little plastic ring, like the spider, like the neon orange spider.
My favorite carnival toy was, you know those rubber domes you turn inside out?
And you you let them.
And they pop up.
Yeah. I still have one in my car.
I love this thing. I still have my beloved rubber dome thing.
I love the balls that were like, they looked like they were spiky, but they were those jello balls. Yeah, those are fun. Throw those at people.
I have one of those in my car, too.
Yeah, remember those Ona holes?
What?
You know, the liquid-filled Ona
holes? Oh, right. You slide
those
through.
Yeah, weird things.
Oh, yeah.
That's a way to describe it, I guess.
Dude, I just described that rubber dome bouncy thing as a rubber dome bouncy thing.
That makes sense, though.
That made sense to me.
I mean, Ona holes also makes sense.
Does it have an official name? Yo, stream chat, let us know.
I guess I just wasn't an adventurous child. If I I never would have thought of it that way.
I definitely didn't think about it that way as a child, but being the corrupted adult now, I'm just like, oh, look at that.
Now we know.
It's instantly sexual. I'm super immature. Yo, are you good at crane games?
No.
Dime-Am?
No,
do you know anybody good at crane games?
Your boy right here.
This is you?
At least I know which ones to play.
All right, well, let me see if I can find the prize that I want. We were at...
That's the biggest problem. You can't be like, I want that. Because that's how you get gods. That's how you really get gods. And that's
Yo, can you win me this on the crane game?
Oh, my God.
I can't show the stream, but this
is that. Hey, I've seen that.
Damn.
Yo, this is... We've walked by, so there's a pale version and, like, a tan version.
So I'm seeing a photo of... That's the Sonico lady, right?
Pochoco.
Who the hell is that?
Pochoco.
I don't know who that is.
It's her chubby friend.
But I want it.
It's her thick friend.
She's thick.
Thick.
I really want to show you guys.
Don't do it. All right. Anyways, we have Izanami versus Kokonoe.
Tsuji on Izanami. That's exciting, actually. I want to see this character do stuff.
No, but button check. Kokonoe, I haven't seen this character in a long time.
Yeah, she's still pretty. She's still got some good set play, but apparently overall she's weaker. I can't figure out why.
Damn it.
What does Izanami do? Like, does she fit into an archetype?
Okay.
Fly around.
She has the hover, which makes her unique right there, but when she hits D, she goes into this mode where she can shoot those things, but she can't block. So she's kind of got a zoning element to her. And then the last very important thing that she can do is she and she has shield. She puts up a shield around herself. It costs her barrier gauge, but it blocks everything except grabs.
Except what?
Grabs.
Oh.
Grabs and special strike grapple moves like Naoto's Phantom Pain.
What about a crush?
Blocks him. Blocks him.
Look at this. Like, what is this character doing?
Yeah.
Wow. I mean, from what I'm watching, Kokonoe has that new move that she stole from, what's her name?
Aegis.
Aegis.
Megiddo Fire.
Kathy. Arcana Heart.
Megiddo. Pretty interesting character.
Oh, 6C.
Calls up that 2B match.
But I still like what Kokonoe's how she plays. She's very fast-paced. Still. Okay.
All right. Bunch of nothings.
Wow. What was that?
One hit.
So she has two teleporting moves. One of them she teleports and hits mid, and it's a bit faster. And then the other one she teleports and hits low, and she can combo from it. And what happened was, he crossed up. He probably didn't mean to do that, but then he got the low teleport and counter hit. It was kind of a silly interaction. There it is.
Wow.
There you go, perfect example of what I was just talking about. She's gonna get pinwheel Oki. Pinwheel shield.
There's a lot of damage from that slide. I'm assuming it's unsafe.
Yes, it is. Unless she has those up, in which case she just shoots the projectiles to cover her.
Wow.
Definitely an accidental input.
Fatal. Okay, nice.
Two hits. I have not seen Tsuchikawa put up the shield once, and it's kind of
back.
Yeah, I'm trying to wait for it. I'm trying to see it.
There it is. So now she's completely invincible.
Like, what do you do? Oh, you gotta throw her, right?
You gotta throw her. You wait, or you wait for the barrier to run out. So now her barrier's gone. She can't do it anymore.
Oh, uses her barrier guard.
Uses her barrier.
That's messed up. Can she turn it off whenever?
She can dispel it.
But
it's
keep your barrier, though? Or it's all gone?
You keep your barrier.
Oh, okay.
But she has lots of Oki setups where you have to respect what she's doing because you literally can't reversal or do anything out of it. Now, he should get one off of this, but he's not. I don't know why.
Wow.
Yeah, what is going on?
Guard button
is kicking in.
Wow. Amazing blocks from the Matoy?
Good blocks by Matoy, yeah. But yeah, this character's jokes. Naoto wishes he could make someone go into guard bonus.
Can't block.
Yeah.
That was a pretty sick side swap.
Yeah. Alright, so what's her ult?
Doesn't matter. Hey! Shields up.
Shields up.
Gotta respect it.
That's wild.
Oh. Wow, press jump A at the right time.
Right as the shield is spelled. I'm waiting for the command grab. Give it to me. Give me the command grab super.
Oh, she has a command grab too?
Yeah, she has a command grab. I want it. I want it. Give it to me. Matoy, give it to me. I want it so
next
bad.
Hit. Oh, wow. Tsuchikawa!
Wow.
I'm invincible, walk up, air throw.
Yeah, so that's why this character's kind of bananas.
Is she good?
Yes.
All right.
Wow.
She's hard.
Okay, so game one.
But she's
Tsuchi.
Good. Yeah.
And I see why.
Yeah. So, like, there are definitely a lot of interesting characters to pick up and play in this game that are good. Like, if you like Izanami, she's good. If you like Kokonoe, she's pretty good. If you like Nine, she's amazing.
Can you jump on?
We need that tag off from the Canadians.
This character's pretty fun to watch.
Yeah, I kind of enjoy watching this. Then again, I haven't played against it, so I haven't
right.
developed the stress yet.
And I'm going to keep it that way.
Yeah. Wow.
Her 2B is so good too. It's so low profile. I'd like to see Tsuchikawa use his Ana air. Her Ana air is pretty good.
Wow.
Shield up. Oh, okay. I guess
burst it.
You can burst it.
Burst.
Imagine if it was immune to burst.
Yeah, that'd be pretty.
That'd be crazy.
That'd be something. He would be riding in the streets.
Okay.
Just outside that range. That was nice. Good spacing by Tsuchikawa.
Did they nerf barrier recovery in this game? It seems really slow.
I want to say that they did.
Yeah. Oh, very cool conversion.
No respect.
Yeah, I like the style of play, yeah.
Alright, set play time. No set play.
Nice.
Behind the back. Oh, it hurts. He's going to have to
right?
burst.
That's death.
Yeah,
right away.
Yeah. Give me the Command Grab Super. I want it. I want it so bad.
Uh-oh.
Does it matter?
What?
Yeah, does it matter? She could just go right through it. Wow.
Thank you for traveling on Air Izanami. Get off the plane. We hope you enjoy your stay.
What the hell?
Cool. Pretty much all I can say. Cool.
Cool.
That character's really cool.
Neat.
Yeah, neato.
Neato.
Neato. Why did I play Rag?
Boy, was that spectacular. Golly gee willikers. I've never seen something so amazing.